I have used many tripods, but none of them were like the Manfrotto 055 X-Pro 3 with the BHQ2 head on it. This is primarily a photography tripod with this head, but you can definitely easily swap this out and put a video, like a fluid head on it, and use it for video as well. You can buy the legs separate. And if you're looking for any of this, all the links will be down in the descriptions, so you don't have to worry about taking notes or anything like that. I never had a good photography tripod because usually most of the time I'm shooting video, so I don't have to worry about it. But this one, I wanted to get a decent tripod with the head. And this thing is, it's made of aluminum. The carbon fiber is a little more expensive and I didn't see the need for it. The max height of this tripod is 71.6 inches and it can hold a payload of about 17.6 pounds. And the head itself holds for another 22 pounds. So you're pretty safe for most of the cameras that are out there. The minimum height on this tripod is 9 inches. That is right. You can get this thing so low to the ground. It's incredible. And with this column in the middle here, also turns like 90 degrees so you can get like some nice macro shots and also be able to get it low to the ground if you are trying to get some specialty, like, I don't know, some cool shots, I guess. Something different where you want to get really low to the ground, maybe a time lapse or something. This tripod folded like this is about 28 inches. The weight of this tripod like this is about 6.6 pounds. So it's a little heavy. I wouldn't say it's a travel tripod. Like you can't just throw this in your backpack and go around. You're probably gonna have to carry it separately because this is pretty heavy on your backpack. It's probably gonna take a toll by carrying this around. So you probably wanna carry it like this, maybe under your arm, I don't know. This setup is mainly used for photography due to this BHQ2 tripod head. However, you can easily remove this and mount a fluid head on this tripod. The reason this tripod stands out to me is because of two reasons. The column, like I said, the center column comes out and it bends about 90 degrees and it allows you to get low to the ground, get some macro shots, some unique shots. The second reason this tripod stands out to me is the ball head friction knob right here, where you can, this, if you loosen the ball head right here, you can adjust however you want. If you want it smooth or like if you want it really loose, you can just turn it all the way. But if you want it smooth but not too loose, you can just keep tightening it. And then you can use this a little bit. You can see you can get a little more friction. I wish more tripods would implement this feature on it because it's pretty awesome, especially if you're trying to use this for both photography and video. You don't want to get like a fluid head for video, but this is great for photography, so you want to go with this. I gotta say, it's a great feature, and I think we should have more tripods with that feature. The built quality of this tripod is incredible. Like these leg locks right here, they come out very easily. You can have this set up in probably seconds. I preferred the quick release locks much better over the screw locks. This is much easier, much quicker to get it set up. You also have a 1/4 inch thread in here, like a little setup over here that you can mount maybe a light, maybe a microphone or something, whatever it may be, like a reflector. If you want to mount a reflector off of this, you can do that, or a magic arm. Also, I love like how these legs unlock. Very easy, you can open it right up, and then if you wanna close it, you just close it and it'll click itself back in place. The fluid motion on this head is just incredible. It's so smooth, and you got bubble levels everywhere. You got bubble levels on the tripod itself, and then once you mount the head, then you got two bubble levels right here. You got one here, and you also have another one right over here. And my recommendation is, if you're gonna use this this bubble level right here, this one, I recommend you open it up a little bit. Don't have your tripod closed all the way. Just pull it up a little bit and then lock it in place so that when you want to get to this bubble level, you can just turn it around however you want, much easier. If you let this go down, it's gonna restrict it from spinning around. Once you twist the ball head in here, and you don't want it to move around or maybe get loose and your camera can fall off of it, you have a screw on the bottom and you can just tighten it up. You don't have to go crazy, but just tighten it up, and then this ball head is not gonna go anywhere. And you can do the same thing if you have a fluid head mounted to it. So the little screw will just keep it in place. The plate that comes with this tripod is a 200 PL, and it's very common. You can get this pretty much anywhere. And it's got like a nice D-ring on it right over here on the bottom, and you don't need a screwdriver or anything like that. So you can just screw your camera on it and you're good to go. And then to get it back in, if you leave it locked like this, you can just drop it in and it will lock itself in place like so. So I'm pretty active in the comments, as I don't have many subscribers yet. So I try to answer to all the comments that I get. So if you have any questions about this or about anything else, just let me know. If you would like to see a video on something photography or videography equipment related, let me know down below. And I'm gonna be making, there's gonna be a lot more videos coming. I'm trying to get back to doing more than just once a week videos. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video.